Okay, in this next video, I want to make a support bracket for the shelves. It looks like this. It's basically an L with a hole in it to support the bottom shelves and the shelves that don't have brackets right underneath them. And so I want to show you how this was developed using Fusion 360. So here's a picture of the shelf that I'm going to be making the bracket for. You can see an example of one of the brackets I made previously sitting on the bottom there. And so it should support the lower half of this shelf and keep it from flexing in the future. You can see that. We'll see when it looks when I look at it on the video. Start out with a sketch in mind and go from there. So let's get started. Okay, you can see we've got Fusion 360 up on the screen now that we're recording. And so we'll walk through the process of how that was developed. So first thing we need to do is build a sketch and decide where we're going to build this on. And so we're going to start out this time with a sketch, and I want to build it from the back out, so to speak. So I'm going to go to the back. So I've clicked on the back. Now this plane is the back of my document with Z on the top and X on the bottom. Sometimes I get turned around on that, so pay attention to that over here. So this is Z, this is X, Y, and this is the plane that I'm looking at. So I start with the sketch, and my sketch is a simple rectangle on the back. So we'll start with the rectangle by hitting R. We're on the back. I'll start my rectangle here. And the back of my rectangle, I want 1 inch wide. And I'm going to want it 1 inch wide, and then I'm going to make it 1 1/8 inch deep. So I'm going to do this 1 1/8. So I have it 1 inch by 1 1/8 inch wide. And so from there, I know that I'm going to want to have a shelf on the bottom. So I'm going to go ahead and create a line, hit line or L. And I'm going to start the line, oh, say right here. It doesn't really matter because I'm going to put a dimension on that. And that shelf, I want to be, hit OK. I want to be 1/8 inch thick. So I'm going to go ahead and dimension that. And I'll take from here to here as 1, 8 or 0.125. Let me do that again, 0.125. And so I've got a 1/8 inch shelf. And from here, I've got 1 inches up. Remember, we had 1 1/8 inch. Take away 1/8 inch. That means I have an inch up from this area. And what I want to do is have the ability to put a hole right in the center area between the two. And of course, this is evenly displaced because it's 1 inch. So I know this is the center. So I'm going to go ahead and put a circle by hitting C for circle. And I want that to be about a half inch or so down. So this be right, let's say right here, it'll be close. Not probably completely on. And I want this to be able to have a little countersink. So I know that should be about 9/32 of a circle for my screw head to fit in there. I know that from measuring previously. So now I've got the sketch. I've got the area right here where I'm going to design the hole to go through to put the screw in. I've got the backing plate, and I've got the area that I'm going to be able to pull out for the shelf. So I'm finished with this sketch. All right, now that I have the sketch finished, I want to go ahead and extrude this piece so it, I typically turn it to the side so that I can get a better angle. So the first one I want to extrude is this one right here. Hit E for extrude. and it is asking me what I want to do, so I'm going to go a distance in this case, and I'm going to start to pull it in the direction I want, and then I'm going to go ahead and put 1/4, because that's how far I want to pull that face out. Then I want to hit extrude again, and I want to pull this face out 3/4 of an inch. So I'm going to put 3/4 of an inch. That accounts for 1/4 inch in the backing and 1/2 inch under the shelf, which gives me good support for the shelf. So that's pretty much the shelf. It would be done, except I like to take off the rough edges. So we'll go ahead and do that now. Let me turn this around a little bit to make it easier to see and do that. So I'll start with putting some fillets on these edges. And so I'll hit the fillet tool up there. I will select this edge, this edge, this edge, this edge, this edge, this edge, and this edge here, and this edge here. So you can see I've selected 8 edges. I'm going to put a fillet of about 1/32 inch, just enough to round the corner so it doesn't scratch you when you're working with this bracket. And now we have, and I'll turn off this sketch so you can see it easier. Now we have the body. One other thing I would like to do is put a little bit of a fillet in here for acceptance of the screw head. So I'm going to go ahead and put a fillet in that area of, let's say, 1/16. Let's see what that looks like. And that will allow the screw head, the construction screw head, when it goes through there to settle down in there, give us a nice small flat area. With that, then I think we've got this built, and now it's time to export it to the 3D printer. Let me hit save. Now I'll go ahead and export this to the 3D printer. Simply come over here, hit 3D print, select. I selected the body. You can now see that turn blue and the mesh in there. You can see it over here. And I'm going to export that to Cura. As I've said in an earlier video, maybe you've seen it, maybe you didn't by the time you watch this one, I set up my Fusion 360 so that I can export straight to the slicing program I use for my 3D printer. You can do the same thing for your other 3D printers, or what you could do is you could actually export this file if you came over here and you could export it to an STL file by picking STL file from this drop-down list. And if you exported it and saved it, then you could just import that STL file into your slicing program, whatever it happens to be. Okay, at this point, we've actually exported from Fusion 360 into my slicing program, which is Cura. And so at this point, if you're not interested in the actual manipulating the bracket in Cura, that slicer, and then printing it out, it'd be a good time to just say so long. I would appreciate you liking, commenting, and subscribing if you liked this video. I don't have very many videos out there at this point in time. I plan on trying to build a library of helpful hints. We'll see how well I do. I've got lots of various interests and distractions, like any other person that is retired, I guess.
And so it's been a pleasure sharing this little bit of knowledge with you, and I'm hopeful it's helped somebody. And have a great day, have a great life. And if you're not interested in the rest of actually seeing how it exported into Cura and then printing, this would be a good time to exit. Please, again, remember to like and subscribe. Thank you. Okay, now the file opened up in Cura for me. Whatever program you would have had, it would have opened up in that. So now I'll take and I'll move this in Cura, and I'll set it up for printing. And I want to print with this part down so I don't have any problems with supports with this open hole here. So I'm going to go ahead in Cura, and I'm going to set this so that it lays flat. And I should have pointed to this face. And we want to lay flat. All right, so now it's laying the way I want it to. Go to move. I like to see it up front so I can watch it as it's printing out. I'm set. I'm now going to slice this. And that easy, we've got this shell support bracket made. I like to name it something that I'll know what it is. So I'll say shelf support, and I want it in my removable drive. So I've got to change which drive it's going to. And this estimates it'll take 26 minutes for this one bracket to print. That's one thing to be ready for, is that the 3D printing isn't something that's super fast. We'll go over to the printer now. Once again, I hope someone found this little video helpful. That's my hope. And if you liked it, please like, subscribe, share, or give me comments on what you'd like me to do in the future. And as I make future videos, which I plan on doing, I can incorporate that information. Have a great day, have a great life, and wishing you all the best.